wanted, but the result you got there in the end.
Yeah, it was that was a good first half. Passes was too long and not enough connection in our game, and then obviously to concede from a throw-in was disappointing. But very, very proud of the team. I think we reiterated at half-time just to play our game. I could sense a bit of anxiety in our passing and not quite clean enough with it. And obviously when you get the ball away, it can make you feel like that. But it was just a case of just some positioning shifts and just reinforcing the mentality. And then obviously we get the only goal in the second half, and then the football flows in, and I thought we were outstanding second half.
Is that a big thing for the players, being able to shake off that anxiety that they had, to be able to pull through and show that character?
Yeah. Can't deny it. As I said, it's when we sort of conceded last week late, and we've had a really good week's training, but then it's a poor goal we give away. But we responded magnificently well, and I think taken away before performance, you always have a belief, and that's what I always feel that Celtic have, and we know that we'll always keep going right to the very end, and that belief, we've seen that in the second half.
There's obviously a lot of noise that you take away from that, just have a feeling of about 3 points, especially the way you got it.
No, listen, if you drew the game, 4 points is nothing. There really isn't with that game to go. It's not insurmountable. But obviously to get the win is important for mentality and also and then convincing of how we play, and if we play with those connections and with that aggression and that mentality, we can we'll win more games than we'll draw or lose. So yes, the second half was absolutely brilliant, and it always seems to be late goals here at Motherwell over the two spells, but no, really pleased for.
I think that's a massive
impact
when you came in half-time. Was that
tactical? Yeah, tactical. Kyogo had a little knock on his shoulder, but we weren't getting anything. That's the reality. Kyogo's strength's running behind and then running into space. But this was a game I felt that you needed that, and Adam can do that, but I think you also need a reference in the team. And as soon as the big guy comes into the game, he sets the game up so well for us. Scores two brilliant goals. His first one's amazing header, great cross by Greg, but his header was absolutely brilliant. And then obviously he makes his first post run and gets the second one. So, I think the guys coming into the game made a really good impact. The young was good in the game. Give us a width, attacked on the outside, and then created space for the passes inside. Palmer comes in, scores a goal as well, gets into the second post for the cross. So, I thought because of the mentality of the team, the quality that they showed, the pitch was a wee bit bubbling. I thought second half they were brilliant.
I think that's 21 goals in the last 50 minutes of the game this season. What does that say about the kind of character of the side? But also, what does it do for the blood pressure?
Well, Celtic's never good for the blood pressure. That's for sure. It never is. But I think, like I said, Michael, it shows the belief, and that has to be at the forefront of everything, you know, because that comes before performance. Because before you go out on the pitch, you need to believe, and that's what we work with the players. It hasn't been the most fluent this season for so many reasons. But now I think we're getting some key players back. That's going to really stiffen it up for us, and it allows to have that base to attack the games. Like I say, they have that belief to keep going. It's what this club is known for, and it's what every group has to have. If you play for Celtic, you have to keep going to the very end.
Just get Callum back and up for half an hour would be big as well.
Yeah, it's massive for us. You just see when he comes into the game, there's no trouble. You're not troubled in the game. And the big guy up front gives a problem in the first half. His strength and size and Cam comes in, just controls that side of it, and allows us to play and get forward quicker because he's controlling the arm and the skills. So him coming back is huge for us.
You spoke there about 4 points was nothing, but it's just the optics, isn't it? Still to start a title race, if it goes to 4 people, writing narratives, as you say.
Absolutely. And I think the story's already written for us. us this season, Tony, and that is the one thing that I again reinforce with the players, that all the noise and everything that's been around this team and this for the, virtually the whole season, we get the chance to write our story. No one else. And that's what we'll do. And when's like today is very, very important for that, for the belief. So now we go into our next game. And like you say, the optics are, we get 2 points. And, very, very close. But I think that's how it's going to be through to the end. But you know, playing with that mentality in the second half. And when we do that, then we look a really good team.
Was that your message at half time? Because the first half, you see, wasn't up to much in terms of you behind at that point in time. And this format at that point, this will be a seismic game, the title race. Did you have to reiterate that at half time? What happened during that period?
It was just about staying calm in that moment. I think that it was more the football and the performance. I think the passes, we were arriving into areas too early, which then gave players less options on the ball, which then meant the passes were longer and they were looking into depth too much. You know, and that's sometimes. You know, what happened in the game, and then at half time it was just stay calm, reinforce the good bits of the game, but actually where we needed to adapt in order to connect the game, because that's what this team is about, so we're running and connection, connecting the game fast, lots of passes, getting into the sides, making runs out behind, okay, getting crosses in the box from half space, wide areas. So tactically we needed to make some adjustments, but all at the same time, stay calm. Stay calm, because it's one goal, and I know this team and I know this club, and once you get into a role and you get your flow and everything, then you can really be aggressive and go and score more goals. And as I said, the players were magnificent second half, got to say, under the pressure of being behind, and they dealt with it really well.
But at the same token, are you going to need to put those half performances of 45 minutes here and 40 minutes there, keep together for 90 minutes for the next 11 games? Because obviously there's been patches of games, but not perhaps 90 minutes.
Yeah, that's the plan. That's the plan, it always is. But if you can't, then it's important that you react. I think, like you say, we've had that. We had it last week at Kilmarnock. And listen, we ourselves brought the anxiety in that game. There's nothing really that Kilmarnock did, with the greatest respect. We brought the anxiety ourselves. And we bring it a little bit today in the first half because of our decision making on the ball and our passing, being a little bit loose enough, quick enough. But once we then organise that and sort that, then the team are very, very good.
Thank you.
Nice, Brendan. Okay.
Thank you.
Cheers. Thank you.